Excellencies, dear friends, and dear members, thank you very much for your participation through digital platform due to the pandemic to this 2020 international convention. The General Assembly is a part of the international convention. The second part is the international conference and will be held on 33 and 30 of October and will respectively deal with the governance and business model and education and the training. Today's General Assembly is being attended by 161 participants, including 104 members of the foundation from 13 countries, representing 27% of total number of members. The foundation is currently present in 11 countries with 27 national or local groups. The activity of local groups in their respective geographical areas is fundamental to the foundation's success. The groups which operate in close connection with the Vatican, the foundation's success with the Vatican foundations through their action and the behavior of its members bear witness and disseminate the Catholic social doctrine, thus fulfilling our institutional mission. The foundation work and the results achieved are set out in our 2019 annual report, approved by the board on March this year, published on our website. I ask you to read it because it provides useful information. For the first time, we have also drafted a mission report in order to make public not only our financial results, but the work we have done to fulfill our international goals. The 2019 balance sheet shows a loss of 14,275.32 euros, essentially due to the new accounting standards issued by the Secretariat of the Economy. These standards require us to enter in the profit and the loss account losses registered by our portfolio investment when market values of a security goes and stays lower than 20% of its book value for a period in excess of 9 months. Until 2019, such losses were reflected in the balance sheet under items reserve securities revaluation. So they didn't enter it in a profit and loss account. Today, I wish to brief you on what the foundation has done in the past 9 months and what is planning for the future. Eutimio will then brief us on the 2019 economic and financial situation in more detail, and Professor Marcel Guerra, coordinator of the scientific committee, will report on the 8 papers submitted by the groups. This paper will be presented and discussed in a roundtable format. I wish to thank Professor Antonio Costa, a member of the scientific committee, for taking care of the challenging role of moderator. A very warm thank to Bishop Celli for honoring us with his presence. His meditation will be a source of great spiritual illumination for all of us. Before the round table, a short video will be shown, which is a part of the Interdependence Film Program sponsored by United Nations in Geneva. So let me now summarize what we have done in 2020. At the end of February, at the Catholic University of Sacred Heart in Milan, we held our 7th consultation on the theme Ethos, Education and Training, Avenue towards equality and ethical behavior in the digital era. The event had a new format. The traditional in-camera session was followed by a second one, open to the general public. The speeches and the various written contributions of the event are all available on our website. In May, we submitted 5 questions to the participants to the consultation, asking which initiatives they had taken in a reaction to the pandemic and which opinion they had formed concerning changes that education and training had undergone. We received from the speakers and attendants to the in-camera session 13 answers. And the consultation acta and the summary of the answers received will be soon presented to the Holy Father and to the relevant Vatican dicasteries on as our contribution to the ongoing work of the Congregation for Catholic Education. In June, July, we held 2 online meetings respectively with the coordinators and ecclesiastical counselors of the Italian and European group. We kept in touch to keep in touch and exchange information. We have asked all scientific committee and advisory board members to answer 15 questions on the impact of the pandemic. We received 11 answers and again drafted a summary published on our website. A written version will also be sent to the interested Vatican dicasteries. We have started a cooperation with the Strategic Alliance of Catholic Research Universities, SACRU, to research how to concretely implement a model of such economic progress inspired by integral ecology. It is an important initiative. We will sign soon a memorandum of understanding. In the future, these initiatives may be extended to other Catholic and the secular universities. As provided per Article 3 of our statute, we promoted an extraordinary fundraising to integrate our annual donation to the Holy Father, to support his charitable works specifically designed to the coronavirus health emergency. As of today, we received a donation in excess of 100,000 euro. We remitted to Papa Francesco 50,000 euro last May and 50,000 in September. Collection is still on, and the remaining portion will be transferred at the closing. Pope Francis thanked us for the first donation with a touching letter, copy of which we sent to you on June the 1st. The 2030 Commission was set up to outline a 10-year strategic plan, completed its work last July. The report was submitted to the board on September 29th last and approved. I trust that some proposals of the plan can be implemented by the end of the year. We will keep you updated. Work on the bylaw amendments is almost completed. I think you will be happy to know that you, as adherent, will elect 2 directors instead of 1, to be chosen among members whose daily work is inspired by the Catholic social doctrine. The elected members, possibly with a diversified professional skills, must fulfill the good repute requirement mandated by Article 8 of Law 211. I hope your choice will include women. New voting rules have been approved. Finally, I ask you to bring our Economic and Society Biennial Award to the attention of your communities, universities, dioceses, and so on. For the first time, the forthcoming edition includes the awarding of 2 scholarships for advanced studies and or research work on Christian social doctrine related issues. The deadline for applying was postponed to the end of December due to the pandemic. The foundation's work can be particularly relevant and useful during this post-pandemic reconstructions. The Holy Father has repeatedly asked us to act in our respective role, not to foster a return to the past, but to promote regeneration, the constructions of a new world, a more just, more supportive, and more sustainable development model. The foundation must contribute to the achievement of such a goal. We are already doing so with our studies through the local and national groups. But above all, we must contribute with our daily behavior in our respective field of work as entrepreneurs, professionals, academics, bankers, politicians. We can bear witness on how to live the Catholic social doctrine, how to reconcile our own interests with the interest of the whole community and respect of the environment. I'm confident we will prove able to set the example, responding to Pope Francis' invitation, and I quote, to measure our existence on Jesus. The choice of faith that we are invited to make cannot fail to confront our daily life, but must be free from all conditioning and hypocrisies to be oriented to God and his kingdom. I do believe in the force of example. Businesses represented in the foundations can embrace production models consistent with the Holy Father indications. As a first step, they could adopt ethical principles and the ESG criteria, be sustainable businesses, and pursue the institutional goals of creating and distributing value for all the stakeholders, not just for the shareholders. They could become green businesses or circular businesses or benefit corporations that are profitable, but in the same time have a positive impact on people and on the environment. In the US and in Italy, there are several positive examples of a B Corporation. After all, the adoption of a sustainable and supportive business model is becoming a must for any enterprise that wants to survive and prosper in this complex and uncertain time. The markets and the consumers reward these companies. It would be great if Centesimus Annus businesses could lead the way of this transformation process. We already have some member companies that are sustainable and resilient. I ask them to inform the General Secretariat of what they are doing to learn and let our members know about their best practice. Our executive and professionals, if they are not already doing so, could apply their transformational skills and the sensitiveness to the implementation of the new development model advocated by the Holy Father. The executive's role is fundamental in fostering transformation and changes inside and outside the company. There is so much need for responsible executives with diversified skills, sensitive and respectful of diversities, ready to meet the need of all stakeholders. Managers who can be inclusive and pursue medium-long-term goals. Managers capable of evolving as a person and as a company. Our academics are doing such a great job. They can strengthen their role as a scientist by studying in the light of the Catholic social doctrine, the difficult transformation from the technocratic paradigm to an inclusive and sustainable one. They can address interacting with businesses the complex implication of such a strategic passage in terms of timing, cost, governance, and organization, and decline the path of a just transition. With your help, we will pursue a double goal: contributing to face the greatest challenges of our digital and post-pandemic time with a supportive and sustainable orientation, and to educate and train a young generation with the knowledge and the skills required by the new world, not just Homo economicus, but a supportive, creative, and relational people. Our future activity must also be inspired by the message contained in the encyclical Brother All, signed by Pope Francis on 3rd October last, a powerful document for moral renewal of politics and economics. I trust our meeting today, through virtual, will represent a meaningful opportunity to share thoughts, to analyze and submit proposals on issues that have proved to have such an impact during the pandemic. Useful reflections were made by our groups on the issues I have mentioned. We will hear it during the roundtable. It's a comfort to see how much our groups achieve with passion and commitments. Warm thanks to you all. Let me say that the foundation is innovative. We are in fact experimenting for the first time a simultaneous translation associated with at a digital platform. Thanks to all that have operated for that. And now I give the floor to the Secretary General for a short briefing on our annual report. Please remember to read it, because it's really an important instrument of information about what we have done. Thank you.